Hey guys, welcome to HIIT TV. I'm Amber, this is Christine. We're so excited to come out with this workout series because now that Amber's pregnant, we could show you that when you're pregnant, you could still have a safe and effective workout. If you want an advanced version, follow me. If you want a beginner to prenatal version, follow Amber. And if you are pregnant, please make sure that you get cleared by your doctor before jumping into any workout. Let's get started. Hi guys, we have another Tabata workout for you. This one's great for your legs and your abs. If you want an advanced version, follow me. If you want a beginner or prenatal version, follow Amber. Our first exercise, squat. So stand with your feet hip width apart. We're gonna go down, up and squeeze. Down, up and squeeze. Make sure the weight's in your heels. When you come up, squeeze those glutes. Use that exhale up, inhale down. Squeeze up on those thighs. Good. Make sure those abs are in. All right, second exercise. We're going for burpees. I'm gonna jump. Amber's doing the modified version. Here we go. Do a nice big jump. Knees in and up. So it's great to get your heart rate up. Good for your arms and shoulders too. Make sure you hold in your abs as you go down. All right, back to your squat. So we're alternating between those two exercises. Feet hip width apart. Here we go. Down, up and squeeze. Down, up and squeeze. Good. How you doing?
Good. I do have going some down and up.
Yeah, take it at your own pace, for sure. Make sure you're breathing during these rest periods. All right, here we go. Back to your burpees.
Now I'm just dropping 1 foot out at a time.
Back to your squat. Feet shoulder width apart. Here we go. Down, up and squeeze. Down, up and squeeze. You could go fast, you could go slow, wherever you guys want to be.
And not so low.
Yeah. Definitely feel your quads. Good. Rest. Burpees up next. Three, go. If you want to take these up a notch too, you could add a push-up on your way down. You go into that plank. Or not. All right. Back to those squats. Yeah, one more. Here we go. Down, up. Make your arms active here too. Squeeze them back. Yeah. Check in with those abs. And rest. Almost there.
Everybody loves burpees.
Yes. Here we go. Good guys, abs are strong on your way down. And I like alternating between two exercises. Then you don't get bored, and it goes by faster. All right, done with that set. Okay guys, our second Tabata we're doing is forward back lunge with a side tap alternation. Here we go. You're gonna start with your left leg forward, and then you're gonna add a little hop, forward, back. So it's really your right leg that's moving. Amber's doing the modified version. Good. Make sure your knee stays over your ankle. Forward, back. Good. Okay. Here's your side tap. Your right leg's gonna go out to the side. Good. So if you want to advance, you're gonna touch the floor and you're pushing off the leg that's bent. Good. You want to flat back. Make sure you're not rounding forward. Definitely gets the heart rate up. Okay. Back to the lunges. Left leg forward. Here we go. Down, hop. Takes a little bit to get that hop when your legs are jiggling. Yeah. Okay. Side tap. Right leg out. Abs are in. Nice flat back. Open chest. Push off the floor. Good, guys. Use that breath. Nice. Okay. Now your right leg's forward. Left leg's moving. Here we go. Sink it down. Add that hop. Hop. Good. Your left side's so fatigued. It feels weird on your right. Yeah.
That's
right. You
can get confusing. Yeah.
Okay. Now your left leg goes out. Right leg bends. Heart rate is up. Good, guys, almost there. All right, last time we're doing the forward back lunge. Right leg forward. Here we go. Sink it down. Add that hop. Good. Oh yeah. It's your lifesaver. Yeah. 20 seconds. You could push. Okay. Last time. Side tap. Good, guys. Push away from that floor. Drive your heel down and push. Almost there. Getting low. Oh, nice job, guys. Okay. Catch your breath. Next thing we're doing, we're going to grab our mat. We're going to go into a little plank series. Okay, our third Tabata series is a plank, a low plank to high plank alternating series. So we're going to come down on our forearms. I'm going to do the advanced version. Here we go. So advanced version, you're going to bend your knees and lift. So it's a little bend and lift. If you're following Amber, you're just going to hold that plank. You always have the option to come down to your knees too. Good. Make sure you're pressing away from that mat. Belly button's always pulling into the spine. Good. And then break.
Yeah, the farther along you get and the harder it is to maintain that form with your pelvis.
Yeah. Is the best. Good. And more advanced, you can always line up your wrists and elbows, making it a little bit harder. A little bend and press. Bend and press. Oh, okay. We're gonna do four of these. And then on the next four sets, we're gonna alternate to the high plank. Good. And you could also engage those inner thighs here too, as you bend and press. Squeeze the glutes. Down, up. And for our prenatal clients, when you work with your abs, you wanna have more of a hugging in than a gentle hug, not a deep contraction. Okay, so this is the last one with our bend and press. Make sure you're inhaling and exhaling. Making sure the shoulders are out of the ears. Down and up. Good. Okay, next four sets, we're gonna go into our high plank. So you're gonna be on your palms. You wanna make sure your wrists and shoulders are in one line. All right, we're gonna go here. For the advance, you're gonna take your knee to your elbow, getting your obliques. And Amber feels good doing it, so if you feel good and you're pregnant, do it.
I mean, it's quite interesting to my elbows.
Yeah, you should definitely feel your abs about now if you're really holding them in, pulling that belly button to spine. Three more to go. All right, set it up. You could also add a little hop if you want to take it up a notch. Good. And rest. All right, last two. Yeah, you definitely feel your arms with this one. All right, set it up. You're crunching in on that waist. Never letting your abs go. Okay, last one. So just have series.
You can also take down your elbows too. Yeah. When you start to have wrist problems, which can happen in pregnancy, elbow tunnel is something because of the increased blood flow. So if your wrists are bothering you, you can take down your elbows to still get better.
Good, nice job guys. Okay, we're on to our fourth Tabata set and this is it. So we're going into mountain climbers, side plank, mountain climbers, side plank on the other side. So we're gonna alternate. All right, here we go. Starting with your mountain climbers. You could see the difference between our two versions. Advance, you're gonna add that hop. Prenatal or beginners, just pull the knees in. Move at your own pace. Good. All right, right forearm will go down on the mat. You're gonna go into your side plank. Here we go. All right, just holding those hips up, working through that right oblique. You wanna reach your fingertips nice and long up to that ceiling, making sure your ear and shoulder stay in one line. You wanna lift up out of that right shoulder, make sure you're not sinking down into the mat. Just breathe. Good. All right, back to your mountain climber.
And I'm not usually a fan of having hips in the air, but if you do need to modify it for prenatal clients, yeah, you can take your hips up just a little bit, take some of the pressure off the mat.
Check in with those shoulders. Make sure they're not going back behind your wrist or into your ears. Okay, side plank, other side. So your left forearm on the ground, wrists and elbow line up. You're gonna lift yourself up, fingertips reaching nice and long. You wanna make sure your pelvis is stacked and that top hip isn't rolling back. It's right on top of that bottom hip. Lengthening up, working that left oblique, belly button's in. You have active legs here too. So you're just holding it nice and steady. Good. And break. All right, back to the mountain climber. Almost done. Here we go, guys. Good. If you're advanced, push through these top mountain climbers. You're almost done. Good. Break. Okay, back to the right oblique side plank.
Yeah, definitely a good option if you need to modify.
So you want to make sure your hips aren't sinking down to the mat. You want to keep them lifted and lengthening up. You can even lift that top leg if you want, wherever you want to be. Holding. Yeah, you could do that on your knees. That's great. Okay, back to the mountain climbers. All right, set it up, guys. Here we go.
When you're pregnant, I'll be the one that has to
Keep going, guys. You're almost there. Good. All right. Side plank, left side. All right, here we go. Lift the leg since we're almost done. Even if you're on that knee, try lifting that leg. Holding. Through everything in the series, I definitely feel my glutes in the side plank. Holding. Nice job, guys. That was a killer workout. We're both sweating no matter what version you're doing. Make sure you drink a lot of water, walk around a little bit to lower your heart rate, and join us next time.